To start now. So we just take a quick recap of that last classifications that Manchester system. There are four stages: stage one, stage two, stage three, and stage fourth. First stage is the when the growth is confined to the breast. Second stage when the growth is confined in the breast, but there are palpable and mobile lymph nodes in axilla. The third stage, when the growth is fixed, means where growth is extend beyond the limit of that parenchyma, of the breast parenchyma, and that skin adhesions and the ulcerations and the tumor is fixed. All these features presents. Stage four, when then the tumor, the cancer is spread to the other nearby structures, nearby organs, and there is involvement of that axillary as well as the supraclavicular lymph nodes. Understand? So there are all in every system there are four stages and almost similar. Next one, that Columbian system. The first is stage A, that similar stage 1, 2, 3 in four. In place of this, there is a stage A, B, C, and D. So stage A, there is tumor is confined to the breast only, no skin edema, fixation to the chest wall, and no axillary lymph nodes. Means nothing is there, but only there is a lump. Stage B. No skin edema, no ulcerations, no fixations, but there is axillary lymph nodes. But the size of the lump is 2.5 centimeters, means less than 2.5 centimeters, and it is not fixed. Either overlying skin, either nearby underlying structures. Understand? Means there is a lump which is less than 2.5 centimeters. And there is involvement of lymph nodes, but the lymph nodes are mobile, not fixed, and their lump is not fixed, lump is mobile. Stage C, when the presence of the edema in the skin, means now the skin is involved, there is a edema in the skins, the mass, the lump is fixed to the skins, so that there is the ulcerations over the skins, over the tumor. The tumor is now fixed to the chest wall as well as the skins, and there is a massive involvement of the axillary lymph nodes, and these lymph nodes are fixed and hard. Understand? Means now the lymph nodes are involved and the lymph nodes are hard and fixed, along with the involvement of the skin and the chest wall. Four, all the feature of stage C, means or whatever the feature of stage C, that all are present in stage D, except means the above of these, there may be satellite skin nodules, involvement in the supraclavicular lymph nodes and metastasis in the distant organ. Means now the same is there. There is a metastasis in the different organs. We have evidence of the metastasis in the different organs, and there is the involvement of the supraclavicular lymph nodes. Understand? So these are the stage D. So there are four stages: A, B, C, and D. These two classifications are almost similar. Next one is the TNM classifications. TNM. T stands for tumor, N stands for nodes, lymph nodes, and M stands for metastasis. So this is the most popular classifications nowadays, and it is more clinically sound, so that if you classify or you know this, it means you must to know this TNM classifications, because these this after this on the basis of this T and M after the physical examination we get one there is a, here also there is a four stages: stage 1, stage 2, stage 3 and stage 4. Every stage has a different combination of T and N and M. Understand? Let's start with the T. T means tumor. So the stages of the tumors means first T0 means there is no demonstrable lump in the breast, means there is no lump. T1S means there is a tumor, but it's a non-invasive. The tumor is in a pre-invasive stage, means it's a carcinoma in situ. In situ means we already had discussed. The in situ means when the growth is confined in a particular structure, is not invading that structures. If the carcinoma is in a duct, so that remain inside the duct. That is called carcinoma in situ. Means when there is a lump is there, but it is in situ. Second, T1. The size of lump is less than 2 centimeters. Skin not involved or involved locally as the pagostin. Means mostly the skin is not involved and the tumor size is less than 2 centimeters. And if the skin is involved, then only local skin is not involved, just above the mass. Then it comes under T1. Understand? T2, when the lump size is between 2 to 5 centimeters. T3, when the lump size is more than 5 centimeters. T4, the size is not matter. Okay, means lump of any size, but when the lump is fixed to the chest wall or the skin, that means the skin as well as the underlying muscles get involved, so that there is maybe the ulcerations, skin edema, puberty orange, all these features are there. Then lump of any size, if it is fixed to the skin, having skin inflammations, having puberty orange, having ulcerations, and having the fixity to the pectoral muscles or the chest wall, then it is categorized under T4. Understand? So these are the six stages in the T: T0, T1S, T1, T2, T3, T4. Understand? These are six stages in the T. Now move to the towards N. N means lymph nodes, means the status of the lymph nodes. N0 means no clinically palpable axillary lymph nodes. If a patient is there and you, while examination, you found there is no papillary axillary lymph nodes, then you mark as N0. Next, N1. In N1 there is two category: N1A, N1B. N1A means you found the palpable lymph nodes, but you didn't suspect the metastasis. Means there may be some other reason of the involvement of the lymph nodes, or the lymph nodes are involved in large in size, but the other overall condition of the patients and the other examination is not suspecting the malignancy, is not suspecting the sorry if other means that that except the lymph nodes, other patients look and all these is not in the favor of the metastasis. Means you are not suspecting the metastasis in the patient, then it is N1A. N1B, when the lymph node is palpable and you are suspecting that these lymph nodes are involved due to the metastasis, then it is called N1B. N2, when you found the lymph nodes which are fixed, solid, matted, understand, means that there is a massive involvement of the lymph nodes, then it is the N2. N3, when there is the supraclavicular lymph nodes are involved. Okay, so in the T1 has T has 6, T then N has N0, N1, N1 in N1 there is 2 means N1A, N1B, N2, N3, the 5 there is classification in the N. Then the M stands for metastasis. M0 means there is no metastasis. M1, there are clinical as well as radiological evidence of the metastasis in the distant organs, either liver, either abdomen, either lungs, either other pelvic organs, bones, ribs. Understand means if there is clinical as well as radiological evidences of the metastasis, it means you have to mark that patient M1. Understand? So now you will get the all three these stages T, N and M. Means you examine the lump, you examine the lymph nodes and you examine the metastasis. Then you categorize the patient in the stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. So stage 1 means that is T1, N0 or N1A and N0. All the T1 means there are only the lump is there, but lump is in the in situ. Okay. Or lump is less than 2 centimeters. In T1 there is two things, not T1S and T1. And M0 means there is no involvement of lymph nodes. N1A means if there is involvement of the lymph nodes, but that lymph nodes are so that and along with this other examination you didn't suspect the metastasis, and M0 no metastasis. If this is just a kind of means you have after examination you give one formula to one patient's staging, just like you do after taking history of that female, and you that gestational history, after taking gestational history you give one formula to the patient, na, that L0, P, G, G3, P2, G3, P3, L2, just like that, na, ki 3 times gravita, 2 times 3 times pregnant, and 3 live birth, 2 live birth, means all that gestational formula. Just like you here you get one formula for one patient for that particular stage. So if a patient get T1, N0 or N1A or M0, it means patient is of stage 1. There is a variation in the stage. Second is the most very much variable, because that stage is having so many variations. Means that T1 means lump size is less than 2 centimeters. N1B means you suspect the metastasis, but after examination you find M0 means there is no radiological evidence of metastasis, then it is stage 2. Next, T1, N0, M0, T0, N1B, M0, T2 means the lump size is from 2 to 5 centimeter, but N1A, you are not suspecting metastasis, and M0 means there is no evidence of metastasis, then it is stage 2. T2 means that is lump size 2 to 5 centimeter, N1B you are suspecting metastasis, but M0 means there is no metastasis, that comes in the stage 2. Stage 3 includes T3, N2, M0 or T4, N2, M0. T3 means the lump size is more than 5 centimeters, and N2 means there is a lymph nodes are involved, and M0 means there is no metastasis. Understand? Means T3 has the lump size more than 5 centimeter, and N2 means the lymph nodes are palpebral and lymph nodes are fixed, but M0 there is no evidence of metastasis. T4 means the lump has fixity. The size doesn't matter in the T4. Lump has fixity, the skin, inflammation, pupae orange and fixed to the chest wall. M2, there is a matted lymph nodes, means involvement of lymph node, and M0, there is no metastasis. It comes to the stage 3. Stage 4 includes any T, any N but M1. So most critical stage means the most advanced stage is stage 4, when there is a clinical as well as radiological evidence of the metastasis, and if a metastasis happen, then it doesn't matter what is the size of lump and what is the character of the lump and what is the involvement of the lymph nodes, all things it doesn't matter. Why we do these classifications, I tell you, because you are when you choose the treatment, because there is very much different in the stage 1 and stage 4, means that the disease prognosis, that chance of the recurrence, and which treatment you are choosing for that particular patient, that is depends on the stage of the patient. Understand? Means your plan of management is totally depends on the stage, means which stage patient is belong to. That's why it's very important, the TNM classifications. Every student must to know and must learn this TNM classifications. It's very important to decide the management of that, to make the plan of the management of the breast carcinoma. So next come to the management of that breast cancer. So the basic thing which you have to always keep in mind while making a plan of management of that CA breast, that first thing is the reduce the local chance of recurrence, and second, to avoid the risk of the metastasis. Means there are two targets. First thing, to cure the local disease and avoid recurrence, and second thing, to stop that metastasis and stop recurrence, so that you can increase the lifespan of the patients. Understand? Next line says, treatment of early breast cancer will usually involve surgery with or without radiotherapy. Means that radiotherapy or chemotherapy. Means there is the the treatment method of that CA breast is depends completely on the stages. Okay, so if you look the whole pictures, there is the two things. First, the surgical management, and second thing, the adjuvant therapy. Means along with surgery, other therapy which there is adjuvant therapy, means these therapy cannot treat the cancer. If there is established case of the cancer, then you must go for that surgery along with this adjuvant therapy to cure the cancer. Understand? Only chemotherapy or radiotherapy or hormone therapy is very difficult to treat the cancer of the established CA breast. Understand? Then these therapy are also called the systemic therapy. That when the complete body is involved. In the surgery, that particular organ is involved, where we do surgery in the breast only. But these systemic therapy, that the chemotherapy or the hormone therapy, these are involved. Systemic involvements are there. When you introduce in the body, then all the systems are involved. So here the how you make the plan of management. Means if your patient is of stage 1, means that is DCIS, that ductal carcinoma in situ, tubular carcinoma in situ, or any special types when there is no risk of metastasis, that is stage 1 on the TNM classification. You have classified this, that patient as stage 1, then only local treatment is enough. Local treatment means that you just target that lump, particular lump. You excise the lump, then you 90% cases you can extend the lifespan of the patients. Second, their low risk means there is a stage 2. In that case, nodes are negative, means all the stages in the second, you see the lymph nodes are involved, but they are not fixed, or there is no sign of metastasis. There may be the lump size 2 to 5 centimeters. Okay, all that conditions of the stage seconds. Here the local regional with without systemic means in this stage second you just choose to first the local treatment, as well as you can introduce some adjuvant therapy as a chemotherapy or that hormone therapy for that with or without, depends on the condition of the patient, depends on the how the patient is responding to that therapy, how the patient responding to the surgery, or what is the general condition of the patient. Along with this, you can go local with or without the systemics. Understand, stage 1 only local, stage 2 local regional with or without that systemic therapy. Stage 3, when the nodes are positive and unfavorable histology, means while the histology of that lump is suspecting that the malignancy, in that case you must go with the local regional with systemic. Here you must introduce adjuvant therapy along with that local surgical management. Understands? The stage 4 is there, local stage 3 and stage 4, means local advanced stage 3 and stage 4, means you can take that advanced 3 or initial and initial 4. The the 4 is that when the metastasis already happened. Understand? Then large primary or inflammatory conditions is there, means that lump is that skin is involved, that is the ulcer is there, the fixed the lymph nodes are involved. In this, only primary systemic. In these two conditions, metastasis stage 4 also, there is a primary systemic one. Means here now the surgery also cannot treat the patient because there is the metastasis already happened. Understand? Until metastasis not happen, till then you can remove, because you can find that the tumor, that cancer is in that particular organ. Up to there you can do the surgery and you can resect that tumor and introduce some adjuvant therapy, so you can treat the patients, so that you can expand the lifespan of the patient. But once the metastasis is already happened, means the tumor is already spread to other organs such like liver, lungs, abdomen, then surgery has no benefit, because the tumor, you cannot eliminate the tumor from the body of the patient because it already spread to the various organs. In that condition, only the primary or systemic therapy, just like the chemotherapy, radiotherapy, and these hormonal therapy are only the treatment of choice. Surgery is not advisable in the stage 4 or in the advanced stage 3 case when the metastasis is already happened. In that case, surgery is not advisable. Only that systemic therapy are advisable to means if the metastasis already happened, it means it is the death is necessary, means it is sure that patient is going to die in 1 or 2 years. So with this systemic therapy, you can reduce the pain of the patient. You can reduce that a little bit discomfort of the patient, but you cannot treat that patient. Understand? So next we talk in the next class, management of stage 1 and stage 2. We just discuss the management stages wise. Here and then previous slide we just discussed complete plan, how to make the plan stage wise. Understand? In this next lecture we discuss in the detail that detailed management of stages wise.